기억이 나면 너를 틀어버리지. 그냥 손이 가는 대로 난 움직여.
Ji Jin-seok, a South Korean singer who first became known when he participated in the reality TV survival series Under 19. He left the show just before the top 19 trainees were announced and later debuted as a solo singer with the digital release of Good Night. Ji Jin-seok was born on the 18th of August 1998 in Seoul, South Korea. He developed an interest in singing as a young kid when he discovered that he could carry a tune. In his 6th grade, he knew that he wanted to become a performer, but when he brought it up with his parents, they both strongly opposed the idea. Jin-seok let it go, but vowed to ask for their permission again when he was older. When he moved from middle school, he again talked to his parents, and they reluctantly agreed as they saw how serious Jin-seok was in pursuing his dream. From then on, both his parents have been supportive of his goals and enrolled him into a music academy to further hone his skills. Do you want to win one of these items on your screen? If so, make sure to watch the whole video, leave a like and comment a hidden message. And with that being said, let's get ready to watch the video. There are no specific details on his educational background, but in interviews, Jin-seok has said that he attended local schools in Seoul for both his primary and secondary schooling. It's unknown if he is currently enrolled into university. Due to his unique voice, he was noticed by the CEO of a newly established entertainment company, Black Y Music, who signed him up as their first contract artist. When it was announced that a mainstream South Korean channel would be holding its own reality TV survival series entitled Under 19, Jin-seok's CEO encouraged him to participate. On the 3rd of November 2018, Jin-seok participated in Under 19, a TV survival show produced by the MBC network in South Korea. Almost 60 aspiring trainees competed to be part of the final 9 members of a temporary boy band, One the Nine. The winners would be promoted and managed for 12 months by an established entertainment agency, MBK Entertainment, home of successful artists including T-ara, Davichi, SG Wannabe, and Hong Jin-young. Jin-seok was excited but also apprehensive since he was the only artist from his company who would join the competition and because he didn't have much dance training. Despite his misgivings, he welcomed the opportunity to learn more as the show had some of the most well-known figures in the K-pop world. The main coaches were Crush and Solji for vocals, dynamic duo Choiza and Gaeko for rap, and Eunhyuk, Super Junior, and Wang Sang-hoon for dance. Special coaches were called in to help the contestants, including J-Hope of BTS, Kai of EXO, and Yoon-ho of TVXQ. He was only 19, but Jin-seok was one of the oldest trainees in the reality show and acted as a big brother. Other competitors were as young as 12 years old. There were 4 rounds of eliminations, and he was able to survive all of them until the last one. His performances were good, and he was doing quite well each episode. However, a week before the final episode and right before the announcement of the top 19 during the semi-final elimination round, the host revealed that he had already left the show for health reasons. Jin-seok was found to be suffering from temporomandibular joint dysfunction, which is a painful jaw condition, and was exacerbated due to the mental stress and physical strain he underwent while competing in the show. It was a double whammy for Jin-seok, as one of the vocal coaches, Crush, who happened to be one of his favorite artists, was supposed to sing with him in the next episode. Jin-seok earned the nickname Little Crush in the show, as his voice is quite similar to the vocal coach. He was experiencing so much pain that he couldn't get up on the stage during the recording of the performance. His talent agency and his doctor decided that it would be best for him to give up the show to take care of his health. It took him several months to recover, after which he restarted preparations for his debut. Due to numerous requests from the loyal fanbase he developed during his time with Under 19, his entertainment agency held many fan meetings in South Korea and Japan prior to his debut. He was sorely missed by his fans, since he wasn't able to say goodbye to them, but only posted a handwritten letter thanking them for their support during his journey in the reality TV show. In the first week of May, teasers were posted that Jin-seok would be making his debut on the 23rd of May, but for some reason, it was delayed for a week, and fans thought he was suffering from an illness again. Finally, on the 3rd of June 2019, he released his debut single entitled Good Night, and also made his debut performance in Errang TV's Simply K-pop on the same day, as well as releasing the official music video of the song that has now accumulated over 820,000 views. He also participated in another reality TV show entitled Burn Up Billboard Challenge, produced by DSP Media and JTBC Studios. It was aired on one of JTBC's YouTube channels, Lulu Lala Music, but it didn't attract much attention from the viewing public. Two more digital singles were released in 2019. Jinsei Oak's second album entitled Tell Me It's Not True was released on the 9th of October 2019, along with another song entitled My Star and an instrumental version. His third digital single, Pretend You're All Right, was released on the 28th of November 2019. In the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic, Jinsei Oak released his first mini album entitled Half Half on the 27th of May 2020. It has four tracks, including the lead track, Just, along with Clue, Impossible, featuring Yixie Mbom, and the pre-release track, Here. He wasn't able to promote it fully by performing the songs with a live audience due to COVID-19 regulations, but visited a few radio stations and made a guest appearance on Arirang TV. Jinsei Oak hadn't yet promoted on any of the mainstream channels since his solo debut, as there are many new and established artists releasing or promoting songs every week. It's not easy to be included in the lineup of performers. There is a major difference with artists being managed by a small company as compared to artists under big entertainment agencies such as YG Entertainment, SM Entertainment, JYP Entertainment, and Big Hit Entertainment. Every time artists from these companies make a comeback, expect to see them on music shows. Unfortunately, Jinsei Oak is under a newly established company, and Black Y Music doesn't have the clout yet to demand a spot on any popular music show of mainstream TV stations. Jinsei Oak, along with other K-pop artists such as Song Jae-ho of MadTown, Kim Dong-joon, and Kim Yoo-joon, took part in a new genre of the music stage called K-popsicle that a group of musical actors recently developed. Instead of importing popular Western stage plays and transforming them for local viewers, they created a stage that featured popular K-pop songs. They've dubbed it the Stage K-pop Idol Challenge, and it ran from the 25th of August to the 8th of November 2020 at Daehaekro Art Theater, SH Art Hall. There is not much information on his personal life, as most K-pop artists are not allowed to date in their first 5 years after debut. This is a common practice in South Korea, to avoid distractions or dating scandals of any kind. Since most K-pop artists start training when very young, the parents or guardians approve of this policy. It is not clear if Jinsei Oak is living in a dormitory provided by his talent agency or if he lives with his parents as he is a solo artist. Other interesting facts about Jinsei Oak include that playing guitar is one of his favorite things to do at home. He also plays badminton with his close friends and is quite skillful at it. During his stint in the reality survival show Under 19, he was given two nicknames, Jinjin, which is earthquake in Korean, as well as the aforementioned Little Crush. Sometimes he's referred to as the Little Prince of Ballad because of his fondness for singing ballads. His favorite local artists aside from Crush are Park Hyo-shin and Naul, while his favorite foreign artists are Justin Bieber and Max Schneider. While he appreciates the global popularity that K-pop music has achieved in recent years, he hopes that the international audience would also learn to appreciate other music genres from South Korea, such as ballad and R&B. Jinsei Oak is 5 feet 8 inches or 1.73 meters tall and weighs 130 pounds, about 60 kilograms, with a lean body. His natural hair color is black, but he's dyed it to a different color each time he has promotional activities, whether it's for TV or a live showcase. He would revert to his natural color once the promotions were done. The same thing happened with his eye color. The natural color is dark brown, but he's been seen sporting colored contact lenses when he's on TV or in live events. Jinsei Oak has an estimated net worth of close to $100,000 as of December 2020, according to sources. Thank you for spending some time with us. Make sure to like and subscribe so you never miss another video. We also handpick these videos, which we recommend you watch next. You can talk to us on all social medias or ask a question in the comments below. Thank you for being with us, and we'll see you back tomorrow.